Today's video is regarding the cutaneous examination of nerves which you are going to perform in a leprosy patient. So there are few things which are you should remember while having this examination. The first and foremost is that you cannot perform this examination with wearing gloves. So because these nerves are very sensitive and you have to feel it with your finger pulse, that's why it is must that you should not be wearing gloves. You can use sterilizer after the examination. Number two, most of the nerves they run over the bones. So you have to palpate it very softly, pressing them on the bones. And it is always a comparison which is important. That is, the right side of the nerve should be compared with the left side of the nerves. And there are many nerves which are have a cutaneous distribution, but few of them are important as far as the leprosy examination is concerned. And I am going to tell you about those nerves while examining. And if you examine these nerves, then it is more than sufficient for you in the examination. So let's start with the examination. So this is the way you are going to approach the patient, and by means of your thumb, you are going first to palpate the supratrochlear. Supratrochlear is medial and supraorbital is lateral. Both of them are originating from the supraorbital ridge. So softly, you are going to feel for those two nerves, pressing softly on the bone. They are not available here. Now, after the supraorbital and supratrochlear, you are going to palpate the infraorbital along the inferior orbital margin. Infraorbital nerve. You can do it two times to be sure. Then the fourth nerve which you are going to examine as well as palpate is the greater auricular nerve. It usually runs over the sternomastoid. In many leprosy patients, the nerve can be seen. And just remember that we are palpating the nerves perpendicularly. Along the course of the nerve, we are going to palpate at right angle to that course. So now the greater auricular nerve runs like this, so the palpation would be like this. Similarly, a full lateral movement and then palpating the greater auricular nerve over the sternomastoid. So these are the two sides of the greater auricular nerve. Then we come to the supraclavicular nerves. We are going to palpate the clavicle and see if there is any nerve trunk over the clavicle. Supraclavicular nerves. Now, the nerve which is the most commonly enlarged in our case of leprosy is the ulnar nerve. You are going to palpate ulnar nerve along the medial epicondyle. So this is the patient's left hand, holding the left hand with your right hand and palpating it with your left hand. So the patient left hand and palpation is with your left hand, and you are going to palpate it in the medial epicondyle. Whenever the nerve is palpated, the patient experiences a tingling sensation. आपको कोई वो चुभन चुभन सी महसूस हो रही? Patient is feeling the, I am feeling the ulnar nerve and he is also experiencing the tingling sensation. The nerve, ulnar nerve, is palpated, palpable in every individual, but it has to be enlarged to a significant extent if the patient is having leprosy. And then it's important that they should be compared the two nerves. So, on the right side, I am going to palpate with my right hand. Again, I can feel the ulnar nerve and it is almost the same size as it was in the left hand. Ulnar nerve, remember, is the most common nerve which is enlarged in patients of leprosy. Then radial cutaneous nerve. For radial cutaneous nerve, you are going to little extend the wrist and then palpate. Since the course is here, running like this, so you are going to palpate like this. You will feel a cord if it is enlarged. Then again on the right, on the left side, little extension and then palpation like this.
Then after radial cutaneous nerve, median nerve. For median nerve, you have to overextend the wrist joint and palpate the median nerve over this flexor reticulum. Similarly, this is a superficial branch of the median nerve. Now we are, after doing this, we have done the examination of the hands, nerves of the hand now. Now we are going to palpate the common peroneal nerve. The common peroneal nerves curves around the head of fibula. First of all, try to locate the head of the fibula. This is the head of the fibula. And the common peroneal nerve rolls around the head like this. So the palpation of common peroneal nerve will be like this. Up-down movement. And remember, the common peroneal nerve is the second commonest nerve which is palpable in patient of leprosy. Aapko feel ho rahi? Matlab the patient is feeling the nerve and I am palpating the nerve. Patient is having this feeling. Yes. Similarly, on the other side, first of all, locate the head of the fibula and then palpate the neck of the fibula. Up-down movement. Now, the next nerve in the leg is the posterior tibial nerve, which is will be palpable behind the medial malleolus. So the nerve runs like this, so you are going to palpate in this direction. Similarly, these are the two deep nerves, now the two superficial nerves. The one is one of them is sural nerve. Sural nerve is running posteriorly on the calf. So for examination of sural nerve, we are going to palpate like this from lateral to medial side. From lateral to medial side. Perfect. Now the last nerve is superficial peroneal nerve, which is running superior in front of the foot. So again, if it is not palpable, you are going to examine like this for superficial peroneal nerve in front of the ankle. So now once you are done with the examination, and if you have any finding regarding any nerve, it is always has to be compared with the finding on the other side. So that's all. Thank you very much.